Are you a tier one member of GEDmatch? Then if so, you have some added functionality in the OnetoMany tool. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on that bell if you want to be notified about upcoming episodes. I've already made a video about the OneToMany tool that is available to everybody who has a free account or the Tier 1 account. But if you are a Tier 1 member, there are some additional features in the OneToMany tool that you should know about so that you can use them to maximize your efficiency in genealogy research. Now over here on the GEDmatch website, when we scroll down, we'll see that in the DNA applications, there are two OneToMany tools, and those are the ones that I went over. The OneToMany DNA Comparison is the old tool from before the GEDmatch Genesis that provides some of the data. The OneToMany Beta has a lot more functionality for it. And then if we continue to scroll down, we see that under Tier 1, there's also two tools, although they're almost the same. There's just a couple of slight differences. So let me go over the one that's not labeled beta, because they're labeled beta and no beta. And then we'll go over the beta one. So this is the OneToMany comparison without the beta. And what we can see is we enter our kit number and then we can change some things and we're going to search. So what is the difference between this and the others? Well, I'll show you a couple of things and then we'll go over to the other one. Now, first off, you'll notice that some of these are highlighted. And what that indicates is that indicates that they are a tag group. And so the non-beta version of OneToMany always has all the tag groups showing. That's the first difference. The second difference really is that as we scroll over, we see that there is autosomal DNA and there's xDNA information. And then that's it. There is not anything that gives us the source of that or how much overlap. And that really is the difference between these two tools, is this has all the tag groups already listed and it doesn't have the source and the overlap information. So let's switch over to the beta and I'll show you that information. And I'll show you also a couple of the bits of functionality that are available in the Tier 1 that are not available in the free version. So here we are at the OneToMany tool that is listed as beta. Now we're going to put in our kit and we can start our search. Now I said before that the non-beta automatically has tag groups. You'll notice up here that one of the options you can actually choose is tag groups. So I'll show you that here in just 1 second. But then the other thing from the non-beta is it didn't have these final two columns. It didn't have the source and it didn't have the overlap columns. Now, the source column just tells you what company that test was from. The overlap tells you how many SNPs it shares in common with the match. And so that can give you an idea of how reliable that match information may be. So right off, we see that there's a little bit of difference in the information that's being provided, but for the most part, the important information is there. Now there is some functionality here that is not on the non-beta version. First off, you are allowed to change your overlap cutoff. And so for instance, if you don't want to see things that are less than 100,000 or 200,000, you can change that information. Or if you want to see things that are all the way down to zero, you can change that as well. So you can just click on the drop down menu and change this, let's say, to 100,000. And then when I search it, it's going to give me a new list that just has more than 100,000 in the overlap. So I scroll down here, I can see on my overlap, hey, all these are either the NA, which means they're from the old GEDmatch, or they are more than 100,000. Next is the amount of matches that it shows you. Now, I believe the default in the free version was 50, but you're allowed to go up to 3,000. Well, in the Tier 1, you are allowed to go to however many you have. Now, I'm going to go and I'm going to select the maximum 100,000. I don't think that I have that many. I believe I only have about 20, 25,000 matches. Next, I want to show you about the tag groups. Now, tag groups is something that you can have none, you can have all, or you can have one. What I want to do is I want to show you each one of these because they're a little bit different. Now, the none is the default, and that's not showing any tag groups. The all is what the default of the other one-to-many matching tool is. And so if I go and I click on my search for that, what you can see is you can see that there are some different tag groups here that are just highlighted by these different colors. One thing with the all, if you'll notice, is that it is going to have all the tag groups for that person. So you can actually see that this person right here, JL-M3, is part of two different tag groups. And so their information shows up twice. And that's one thing just to be aware of as you're looking at your match list, because you don't want to think that you have more matches in some particular area when really all it is the same person. They've just been tagged in different groups. So just be aware of that on all. Now, if you want one, this information up here says it's going to show only one row for each person, and it's going to just do a random tag group. So I'm going to go down, and there is JL, who has a green and a mustard yellowish color. Well, now on one, I'm going to search, and I can see that JL shows up as the green. So that is the one tag group. Now, the other great thing about the tier one is we're able to use this select column. Now, if you remember on the one-to-many tool for the free version, you had the select column, but you weren't allowed to actually click these boxes. Well, now I can go through and I can click these boxes. And what that's going to do is that's going to put a lot of kits over into the visualization options. So when I click on that, it goes over to the visualization options. And this is also called the multiple kit analysis. And I'm going to have some other videos that go through a lot of these different things. But this is very useful for taking a look at different aspects of a group of people's DNA. And you can quickly select that right from the match list on the one-to-many. There are more features of the one-to-many that are the same thing that you can find on the free version. So if you'd like to learn how to use some of the features of this tool, then go and review that video on the one-to-many. And if you have any questions about the tier one one-to-many, put it in the comments below and I'll try to answer it. And if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with all your friends.